Yeah, I know. I know. Yeah. Yeah.
She was the nicest.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's so nice. She's...
First reading is from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seem in the view of the foolish to be dead, and their passing away is not an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace, for if before men indeed they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of it itself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. In the time of their visitation, they shall shine, and shall dart about as sparks, though stubble through stubble. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love. Because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. brothers and sisters, knowing that the one who raised the Lord Jesus will raise us also with Jesus and place us with you in his presence. Everything indeed is for you, so that the grace bestowed in abundance on more and more people may cause the thanksgiving to overflow for the glory of God. Therefore, we are not discouraged. Rather, although our outer self is wasting away, our inner self is being renewed day by day. For this momentary light affliction is producing for us an eternal weight of glory beyond all comparison, as we look not to what is seen, but to what is unseen. For what is seen is transitory, but what is unseen is eternal. For we know that if our earthly dwelling, a tent, should be destroyed, we have a building from God, a dwelling not made with hands, eternal in heaven. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. We are gathered here to pray for Elaine. Though in sadness of heart to leave Lord Lorraine in the hands of God, and we lost a very beautiful lady, woman dedicated to God, dedicated to church, of course, her family, and with a sweet smile. vital that she always had present here in the church, as I know her this last 5 years being here. And many years since she has been here at St. Bernard's, living just 1 block from our church.
Wasn't
moments of difficulties, of discouragement, or when we, says here, when there is the weight, the burden of life. And what do we do with it? Faith tells us, Lord, today, come to me, go to the Lord, and I will give you true rest, true answer in front of our situation. This we speak about that I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest, because my yoke is easy, my burden light. So this is our answer in faith, that faith itself gives us the security that we have inside of us, life immortal. And we are not to be called like a superhero or whatever, but we are called to have the certainty that even death exists in our lives, suffering, difficulty, sickness exists, as we know, but this doesn't kill us in itself. Faith overcomes all the situation. The risen Lord that is present with us has conquered death for us. So this resurrection is my resurrection. Our resurrection, the Lord, and in this moment that all of us is awaiting death itself, won't be the last thing in our lives. Faith gives us the certainty that we are called to live eternal life with the Lord. Let us put our faith today in this mystery, but it's something tangible. We could see it in our lives. Life and names, and that we can look forward, not to be afraid in the moments of difficulties, of struggle within us or in our lives, that God is present even in these moments. Says, come to me and I will give you rest. I will give you the solution, the answer in front of our situation, even death itself. As we continue this funeral mass today, as we have placed on Elaine the white pall, which is a sign of the new garment that she will be dressed in heaven, the white garment that she has received in baptism. We place in front of Jesus as the light of Christ. Place ourselves also, that faith in us can help each one of us today to follow the Lord. Let us pray.
Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church, confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus. We join our prayers for his.
Let us pray for Elaine. In baptism, she died with Christ. May she now share in the fullness of his resurrection. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God is full of mercy and compassion. May he forgive Elaine any sins she committed through human frailty. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sorrowing family, relatives, and friends of Elaine, that you may find strength and consolation in your Christian faith and in the love and support of this community. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of all consolation, help us to comfort one another in our grief, finding light. We pray for all those who have loved, who have died. Lord, give them the reward of their goodness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who care for the sick and dying, especially those who cared for Elaine during her illness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May the prayers of Mary, the Mother of God, who stood by the cross as her son was dying, help those who mourn and be with all of us in our time.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, our good for all his holy church. Be stand. Look favorably, O Lord, upon our offerings, so that your departed servant and name may be taken up into the glory of your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to hold you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb, who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore we come to pass our joy in every land, and your people exalts your praise. And even the heavenly powers of the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as day and day.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son,
glorious resurrection and ascension into heaven, as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognize the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Bernard and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for our failing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Bernard, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, and all the clergy, and the entire people we have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleased to you. Pray for Elaine, that you call from this life to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body, to our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you, and their passing from this life give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes, and when you will, for seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who hold the supper of the Lamb.
Grant and pray, Almighty God, that your servant Elaine, from whom you have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our
To your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Elaine of the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give thanks for the blessings which you bestow upon Elaine in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to our servant, and help us who remain here to comfort one another with the assurances of faith, until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever, through Christ our Lord.
As we finish the celebration here in the church, we'll be accompanying Elaine from her place of rest at Calvary Cemetery.
The Lord be with you.
May your spirit.
May Almighty God.